Welcome back to the garden. Today I want to show you my secret of germinating seeds successfully.
As many people before, I've been struggling for a while to get a good germination rate out of my crops, especially peppers, leek and onions. Peppers were the particular hard one. I have been trying everything and anything to get them to germinate, and out of 10-20 seeds I had one or two pepper plants come up. So I had to come up with an idea or something to make it easier for me and get them germinated. This thing is not expensive or anything, and it's perfect, it's for free. I have tried these flimsy things. I think it's the absolute waste of time. You're buying a plastic product, so you're creating more plastic. You're not reusing anything, so I think this is a waste of time. The next thing I have tried is these trays. They work great in winter when there is not too hot, but when it's too hot, they're not as good. I mean, they're a bit better plastic. They will last you longer than this stuff. But so what I decided, right, this didn't work. I'll buy one of these. So I was putting a tray inside a tray. Well, that meant this thing was waterlogged. So again, yes, it had enough moisture, but my seeds were getting rotten, or because of so much water, they didn't germinate. Again, you're buying plastic, maybe it's a bit better because they last much longer. Nowadays I just use them to put my little pots in there and carry them around. And now to my secret. These styrofoam boxes are my secret. You got a shorter ones and you got deeper ones. Now, yes, they're styrofoam, but I get them for free from my grocer, from my green grocer. Now, they use them to package whatever fruit and vegetables in there, and they get go into the bin. They give them away for free, and I give them a second life. These particular ones I had for about 3 to 4 years now. Now, what this does to me? First is, I put about 10 centimeters of soil in there, roughly 4 inches. That means the soil will keep enough moisture when I rotate it in the afternoon till I come back from work the next day. Also, if you get a cold night, this styrofoam will insulate your soil and it won't cool down as quick. It means a lot for the plants, if whether they're gonna germinate or not, this little extra protection. Now, if you don't have a greenhouse like I do, what do you do? Or if you need some extra warmth for your seeds to germinate and you don't want to use heat mats, which I am not a fan of, what I do is I grab Glad wrap, use the taller one, I get Glad wrap and put it on top. This gives me instantly an extra greenhouse or an extra layer of protection. What that also does is keeps the moisture in, so even if it gets much hotter, the moisture doesn't evaporate, it stays in the box. So I'll fill this container up with soil, and let's say you have planted your seeds in at night, given a good water, you went to work in the morning, in the afternoon came back, and you see what happens with the trays, whether you need to water them again or what happens to them. So what I'll do is, now I won't be putting any seeds in today. We are still getting really cold mornings. I'll wait for another week. So if you want to see next week what I'm planting, please subscribe and hit the notification bell, and you will see what I'm up to or what I'm planting for my spring summer garden. Now on the other note, while we are here, I've been propagating pomegranates. I see here four of them have started getting, out of six, have started getting leaves on them, meaning four are 100% alive, which is, I think, a good success rate. So if you want to see how to prune your pomegranate tree, or how I prune my pomegranate tree, and how I propagate pomegranates, how you get free pomegranates from your old pomegranates, check out my video. Alright, let's make this comparison and experiment. Here I've got a bag of shop-bought soil, so everything is gonna go into that bag. So soil is gonna go into this from the bag, into my secret thing, and in here. I will not use this tray because it's just the water is just gonna sit in here, so I'm not gonna use the tray. It's gonna be a waste of time. Down as you normally would. Again, no seeds this time, still too cold, but next week make. I'm in my greenhouse. Let's pretend I have planted that, and I will put them on the floor just to make sure the test is the same. So they're roughly on the same spot. I don't have enough room in here, it's just crammed, it's small. So let's pretend I've planted these out. I'm gonna give them a good watering, and I'll come back tomorrow from work, which I will, and I'll show you the difference. Now, like I said, I'm putting these on the floor just to make sure they roughly have all the same conditions. So everything gets watered well, roughly same conditions, everything is sitting on the floor. I'll leave it to tomorrow and I'll see you tomorrow. I've just come back from home. We didn't even have a hot day today, but this is what I have found. So this is usually what I find. This thing is dry. It's all dried up. The soil is black, obviously, but it's dry. Same thing here. The corner ones, especially the corner ones, are fully dry. And when you look at this one, look, you can see it's all nice and moist. So this makes a big difference. Now thank you all for watching. I hope this will help you germinate better your seeds, and thanks for the all the new subscribers, I really do appreciate it. I am by no means a professional YouTuber or recorder. It does still feel a bit funny talking to myself in the camera. I think I'm a bit crazy, but I'm guessing I'm getting slowly more comfortable, and hopefully the videos will get better as we go.